Very good morning. Welcome back to the main arena here for the East Anglian Staffordshire Bull Terrier display team. And I'm going to introduce you to the ladies who will be talking you through this. First of all, Christina Chapman and also Leslie McFadgen. So put your hands together, please. Give them a big round, warm welcome here at the NEC for the East Anglian Staffordshire Bull Terrier display team.
Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. You're in for a treat. You're going to be entertained by the wonderful Staffords of the East Anglian Staffordshire Bull Terrier display team. You're also going to see some of their tricks and their favourite circus performances. And don't put your lunchbox on your knees, there's some of them who are hungry. First up, we have Joe and Mouse. Not a little mouse, a mighty mouse. Don't blink or you'll miss him. Oh, well done, Mouse. And as Joe and Mouse are leaving us, we've got Avril and Izzy, and one of Izzy's best friends, this is Jersey. And one important fact you may not know about Staffords is that they are one of only two breeds recommended for their suitability to be with children. And you can see here how this works. Oh, well done, Izzy and Jersey. Oh, and of course, Avril. Our next dog in is Murray. He was named after Andy Murray, and like his namesake, he's going from strength to strength, certainly active and agile. Thank you. Well, he thinks he deserves a play now. Well done, Murray. Now we have Kirsty and Roxy. Roxy had a leg injury earlier in the year, but she's now recovered and eager to show off her agility. We're glad to have you back, Roxy. That's Roxy. Her agility's fine. She just needs a little more practice at counting the numbers of poles. Next, we're going to have Squirt and Ali. You may have seen Ali on the TV. She works at Battersea. Well, she goes in there. We think the dogs do all the work. No, she's decided she's not going to have a go at that. I think it looks a bit like hard work. Oh, and the dog's tired out already. Squirt is a Battersea dog. Just shows what a little bit of love and attention can do. We understand that there's a little bit of a fan club here for Squirt and Ali. Are you in? Sorry, I can't hear you. Oh, I guess there's a couple in. Thank you, Ali and Squirt. Now we're having Joe and Queenie. Queenie is fast and furious, little Dutch girl. Queenie is mum to Jersey and Tiger, who are also with us here today. And she's just become a grade 7 agility dog, so no surprises there. She gives a whole new meaning to the word the Flying Dutchman. It's a Flying Dutch girl in this instance. Queenie and Joe. Now I'm going to hand you over to Leslie, who's going to cover the next bit.
Okay, so we all know that Staffords love food. They also like to use their noses a lot, and our next couple of demonstrations are going to show you just how much. We've got some scent work going on. Now, a lot of Staffords are actually used to detect wildlife and carcasses, which can be invaluable in conservation areas. And now you're going to see our little incredible Hulk, who's just over only a year old, and he's learning those skills. Now, he's been training to use a particular, to track a particular animal's scent, and today it's a bat, which is a protected species. You can see the tins going down here. Now, the last tin that goes down will have scent of bat, and that's the one that we want him to find. Obviously, they're all the same colour, so he's not cheating, we don't know which colour, but that one that you can see going down now is the one that we want him to find. So when he does find it, he'll indicate to Rachel, and now let's have our little apprentice show off his training. I think he got the right one there. Now, I think you'll all agree, for a very young dog who's only just in training, especially to come and do that in such a big arena, that's marvellous. Watch out for Hulk in the future. So we'll just clear up his bits. And then into the arena next, we're going to watch the professionals at work. So now, first of all, we need our friendly robber to set up our scene. He's going to hide away his stash. We have a couple of bags here with some money in. And what's going on here is our special guest today, Stella, found herself in West Hatch Rescue Centre at Taunton in Somerset, abandoned and unwanted. Fortunately, her gift for scenting was recognised. Now she lives with PC Claire Todd from Trifles Gloucestershire Dog Section. She also is very well known for having found £25,000 in cash hidden in a bedroom. She became an Animal Hero Award for that. She went from rescue to hero dog. And today she's going to have a look round here and see if she can find some cash. Now, if she finds it, similar to Hulk, she'll freeze. And she'll indicate to Stella that she's found the cash. Got a very waggy tail going on, something interesting. And just to prove that there is actually cash in the bag and we haven't just put a bag down, Mandy will show you the very cash. There's the cash in the bag. But of course we all know, although Stella doesn't, that we saw him plant two bags, so we need to find another one. We need to carry on working. I do believe Stella's got her own fan club as well. I know she has a Twitter account, an Instagram account, a Facebook account, and I do believe there are some people who have come today, especially to see her. Looks like something of interest there, and a very good freeze. Let's see if we found that other one. And a lovely reward. And in there we go. There is money in those bags. Ready for Stella. Now, we saw the robber, but Stella didn't, and PC Claire Todd and Mandy didn't. I think he could be in the far corner. Somebody looking shifty over there. Uh-oh, looks like the game's up, pal. You're nicked. Cuff him. Cuff him and take him away. And can we have a massive round of applause, please, for our special guest, Stella? I'm sure some of you would like to have a photo opportunity after with Stella. Please come and see us by the benching.
I need to borrow that dog. I could do with it finding me some money. Right, you're now looking at Jersey's sister. This is Tiger, again, with Joe. And it's just so clever in the agility ring. It's another Jabberwolf star in the making. Oh, well done, Tiger. I wish I had that much energy. I don't know what she's on, but I want some. Right, next we have a double act coming up. Last year, Joe and us in the arena announced Bacon's retirement. Bacon had other ideas, and this morning got in the van and refused to get out. She's 13 years old and will not retire. She's going to show you some of her balancing skills in case Joe sends her off to the circus. Clever girl. Now, over the far side, we have Buzz. This is our intellectual dog because he can read. Leslie is going to take some cards. Have you shuffled them, Leslie? Oh, I guess you have now. I told you to take more water with it. Okay, we're going to hold the cards up so you can see what they are. You can see them on the overhead screen. And then we're going to find out if Buzz can really read. That's his paw. Okay, you can see the next one. What does this one say, Buzz? Thank you very much, Buzz. We're now going to see Bacon and her hoop. This is just a hoop with tissue paper, but Bacon doesn't know that. This is a faith test. It looks solid to Bacon, but she trusts that Joe wouldn't do that. Well done, Bacon. Now, Buzz apparently thinks he misspelt one of the words or misread it. So, oh my goodness, she shot him. Oh, poor Buzz, what punishment. Thank you very much, Buzz. Our next dog in is Dakota, who lives with little Izzy, who you saw right at the beginning. Now, Izzy has been perfecting her handling skills and wants to show Mum Avril that she's every bit as good as her, if not better.
Tomorrow, I wanna settle down until tomorrow.
Yeah, I think we have a couple of stars there in the making. Well done, Dakota and Izzy, with a little bit of help from Avril.
Okay, and for our finale today to our display, we have a most wonderful, magical, mysterious trick here. So welcome into the ring, please, the dynamic Darren and the bewildering Blake. And today you are going to see a Staffordshire Bull Terrier disappear. Have you ever seen one of those before? Well, make sure you're watching. Now, first of all, we need to pop Blake away in his crate because we need to make sure we can get the magic trick sorted. So in you go, Blake. Darren will show you that those doors are very securely shut, shut tight, and he'll cover him over so that he just keeps him quiet for a minute, a bit like a parrot in a cage. Fabulous, all covered. Darren, what are you doing? Leave a man with a duvet, you never know, do you? So now we'll show you our magic box, and like all good magicians, we will show you that the box is empty to begin with. So, if we turn that around just to show our audience, we have an empty box. Oh dear. Star turn. Well, we didn't need to worry about getting the dog out of the crate because he sorted that one for himself. Thank you, Blake. Of course, that was meant to happen, you know. So now we'll pop our dog away in our box. And he'll give you a little wave goodbye. He's a bit shy now and again, but here he'll wave. And we'll shut him in and shut this box up. Close the lid. You can see he's all shut in, nice and tight. No, now you can see underneath. He's not obviously going through the trap door. Okay, shut that lid. And to make that dog disappear, we need a magic word. The magic word is...
Expecto Patronum!
And it certainly is Expecto Patronum, and we open it up, and our dog has... disappeared. No dog. What have we done with that dog?
Check under your seats, folks.
Well, that could be the end of the act, really, I suppose, but perhaps we better get him back. Now, if you remember when I introduced him, his name is Blake. Would you like to call very loudly for Blake, and we'll see if we can get him back. Let's give him a shout. Very quiet. Louder. Maybe loud enough. Let's see if he's there. There he is, our very own trick dog. So there you go, just to show off, through his hoop and take a bow.